that point
that,
in the Prime
that
Minister's
in any case, that in any case, one second, that in any case would happen if there was transparent bidding. Whoever came would still be paying income tax. Whoever came would still be meeting
so
with the
government. So you trashed what the Prime Minister said.
But this loot that has happened, that is why, as I said on Friday, Reliance Energy could sell shares worth 2,600 crores for 2 lakh crores. Sorry, 1 lakh 2,000 crores.
Now, Renuka Chaudhary has a counter question for Bharat Kumar Rao. Before I come to you, if you allow me, please, because I don't want to lose the drift of this argument, I'll allow Renuka Chaudhary to come in and respond to Naresh Gujral. Now, all the figures are not inappropriate. He also said, Naresh Gujral on Friday's news, Nifty goes up twice. The shares of these companies go up 8 times to 45 times. He's got his facts. He's made discreet inquiries. Some of these figures, he's got papers. He's going to show it right now on the news. Renuka Chaudhary, your rebut to the Akali Dal Member of Parliament, please.
Arnav, I want to ask, what was not transparent about the system that they practiced? Well, while the NDA government was there, these were the very norms they went by. Why did we consult the state governments? Because even when we mean well for them, they get hysterical and say, oh, we are quasi-federal and you're stepping on our federal toes. All right? Is it an independent decision taken by an individual at the center? Not at all. Where are the coal-owning states lying? They are lying in the states where the BJP is in power, barring Maharashtra, where we have 4 coal block areas. The rest of them are lying with the BJP governments. When we initiated the discussion with them, they all got hysterical and said, no, this cannot be allowed. We cannot have this bidding process because it will drive the prices high, and hence some rich businessman can come in from somewhere, buy our coal and set up an industry somewhere else. We want the benefit to come to our state, which is fair enough. And then they are the ones who take the benefits of this whole process.
Why are you washing
and
your hands off?
This is not transparent.
Did you not have this
is opaque.
Did you delay it deliberately? Did you?
We should not have taken legal opinion.
Renuka Chaudhary. Renuka Chaudhary, do you accept?
You want an argument? Come to Parliament.
Would the government
come to Parliament and debate it there?
You
don't
make that point repeatedly.
A discussion and a debate in Parliament dilutes the issue. I can't believe this logic.
No. In one case,
that is not.
In one case. I'm not mentioning the company, Renuka Chaudhary. In one case, Naresh Gujral says this company's share in July 2006 is 13 rupees. In December 2007, it is 90 rupees. That is an increase of approximately 675%. 675%.
Yeah, but this is even without excavating, isn't it, Arnav? Has the coal been excavated?
Precisely, even without escalating. So you're making the point. Even without
if it is
excavating.
No, 1 minute.
Yeah, that's it. That is the point.
You hedge against the market speculation.
Let me make a point here. I gave the figure. Just let me make a point here.
Amount of money and runs away.
One sec. I apologize to Bharat Kumar Rao for keeping
runs
him waiting. But Naresh Gujral wants to make a counterpoint to Renuka Chaudhary. Naresh Gujral, go ahead, please.
Even without mining,
yes,
JSW Steel, their market cap on 31st of July 06 was 3750. They got the license without mining. Their market cap goes up to 18,600 crores within 17 months.
How may they?
GVK Power.
Naresh Gujral.
Market, one second, let me finish. I did not interrupt you. It's not fair.
Okay.
GVK Power. It goes up from 346 crores to 1,907 crores in 16 months. JSPL, 4,570 crores to 47,300 crores. Sterlite, from 21,000 crores to 51,250 crores. This is when they have not mined. When they start mining, my God, these figures will be astounding.
Is Mr. Gujral willing to bet and guarantee that the prices will go up and after they go underneath,
absolutely.
They find what kind
because
of coal and what quantity?
Because the landed
to be
madam,
prophecy, that
madam,
number,
madam, the landed
two,
cost today is 5,500 rupees a ton. NTPC is paying that price.
Government.
Okay, gentlemen, I'd like to now bring in Bharat Kumar Rao, who's been raising his hand. I apologize to the Shiv Sena MP for coming to you late. But I want to come to all my guests point by point in so that each point can be made in detail. Bharat Kumar Rao, now I was told this morning that there is an informal summons in the Shiv Sena, start preparing for a midterm election. I know we are getting a little technical in this debate. Tell me, to what extent is it true? A, politically speaking, are polls inevitable? Or are we, this country cannot have a legislative logjam? We can't have a legislative logjam, can we?
Thanks for allowing me to intervene at least after some time.
Thank you.
Here, what I would like to say, what diktat or what suggestion or what information that Shiv Sena has given to its MPs is besides the point. That is not for public debate, because that is not for public
consumption. No, that's what people want to know, that if you are disrupting the process, surely you have something up your sleeve. And on the news hour, I don't want to go around in circles. Please tell me what is up your sleeve. See, for example, I am told there are some meetings going on in Central Hall. I was told that a certain senior BJP leader had a pre-appointed meeting on the outer ring of parliament with one senior SP leader, one BSP leader. The SP and the BSP leaders told the BJP leader, we'll say one thing, we'll do another. If there's going to be a trust vote, you'll have to take a position. Please don't dodge the question of whether you are trying to push for an early election. As is rumor, 3 to 4 months after Gujarat, Bharat Kumar Rao, is this the run-up to that general election?
See, listen, I think that now the early elections seem to be inevitability.
Inevitable,
because,
okay.
Because, let me do this, because this government has lost its moral mandate to run the government. It has no business to be here even for a second hereafter. This is because I am not getting into the history. I don't want to dig the history. Only thing I am saying, the point in question here is the CAG report. In CAG report, whatever allegations have been done, which Prime Minister has said, I am morally responsible. Having said that, the next question is, if he is taking the moral responsibility, earlier in CVC case, he had taken the moral responsibility, did not go. Now here, at least that time the Prime Minister office, Minister of State was involved. Here he was the minister. And despite that, this has happened. Having said that, if the Prime Minister is taking moral responsibility of what has happened, it means the next question is that what does he do about it? That he has to take the punishment and the punishment.
No, that's not going to happen. No political party, when it hardens a position to this point, ever compromises. The BJP is not going to compromise on the demand for the Prime Minister's resignation. The Prime Minister, the Congress is not going to give up on the Prime Minister.
Arnab, let me complete. Here the situation is that now why we want the Prime Minister to go, because we are also demanding full-fledged inquiry. How come the inquiry become effective if the same man is at the helm of affairs, not even the Minister of Coal Ministry?
No, but
the Prime Minister.
No, one second, Mr. Rao.
The inquiry has to be really
Mr. Rao, this question.
The Prime Minister has
no,
to go.
I believe that this strategy that the opposition is pushing is aimed at an early election. So, please tell me, yes. Dr. Chandan. No,
we
no.
We are not.
You are.
We are not pushing. I am saying that is the political and moral inevitability.
Obviously.
That this government has lost its moral right to be in the seat.
And
therefore, it has
so tell
to
me,
move.
Renuka Chaudhary, can you have a situation where you say, we don't care? Let Parliament not function. Let this logjam continue. Let them continue doing what they do. We stay in government. They continue to boycott Parliament. How long will this logjam continue? How long is it feasible? This session, 1 week, 2 weeks, or 2 years?
Arnab, the various managers who manage these affairs on both sides are sitting and working. That's not the issue. The issue is the political bankruptcy of the opposition. How can they deny the people the right to hear? They're elected by the people. How can you deny the right of the citizens, especially when we, as UPA, gave them the right to information? How do you say that they are not entitled to listen to what the Prime Minister has to say? You are doing a shoot and scoot. You think that you can just raise issues
no,
like
so
this
what,
and
what
run
is,
away
what
from
is the backroom negotiation
fact,
then? If there is no negotiability, you just
well,
said the managers
the
are sitting and talking.
Whatever the backroom negotiation, I'm not part of that negotiation.
No, I just
but
want to.
I am trying to tell. I am asking
Ms. Chaudhary,
the BJP and the
Ms. Chaudhary,
other parties who are sitting there, that do you believe that this is the way?
Ms. Chaudhary,
do you actually endorse this?
Ms. Chaudhary and Dr. Chandan Mitra.
If you're so confident about your figures and this knowledge that you think you have, Why don't you come to Parliament and say it? We are supposed to be the accused. They're accusing us. We are not backing away. We are saying
who is being invested? No, tell me one thing.
Come and
do, do you? Do you?
Why are they talking on national TV?
Renuka Chaudhary. Renuka Chaudhary. Renuka Chaudhary. One obvious solution in all of this is to say that we will not just investigate those who benefit. We will investigate those who. We will not investigate just those who benefited. As in, we will not just investigate the private companies. We will investigate the screening committee. Now, I find that surprising. The screening committee is...
You will investigate the chief secretaries. You will investigate the entire bureaucracy.
Yes.
You will investigate the screening committee.
Why not?
Everybody is guilty and corrupt except the BJP.
No.
One second.
When the CWG scam happened, the CWG scam was carried out by the CWG organizing committee. They took the real decision. So my question to you and to Dr. Chandan Mitra is one way out of this logjam is to say, okay, the Central Bureau of Investigation will investigate the screening committee. It will investigate the politicians. It will investigate the bureaucrats. What do you think, Dr. Chandan Mitra? Is that something which can be looked at?
Arnab, that is secondary. The investigation will, of course, happen sooner or later. Sooner or later it will happen, and I hope it will be a Supreme Court directed inquiry.
No, why is it secondary?
And because right now the question is that this government, which is presiding over loot after loot from CWG, Adarsh,
Dr. Chandan Mitra.
One minute, let me complete. Any longer the government lasts, there will be more.
But Dr. Chandan Mitra, you want the Prime Minister to resign. You want the Prime Minister to resign. But you don't want to expose the screening committee to a CBI investigation because that will also include secretaries and politicians from BJP ruled states.
Our position is very clear.
Anybody who is guilty must be probed and punished. But that process must begin with
absolutely
the Prime Minister,
this
who
is
must
what
accept
we are
moral
saying.
Responsibility and accept moral responsibility and resign today. He cannot preside over an inquiry. He cannot remain in office while there is an inquiry.
He is responsible
directly.
Directly,
he is responsible.
Don't interrupt.
I will be forced to interrupt you. No, you don't. Do not interrupt while I'm talking. I will interrupt you otherwise.
You have been interrupting Parliament, Mr. Mitra.
No, I have not. No.
You people have been interrupting Parliament.
I will interrupt you for every word.
Okay, let's continue, please.
Chaudhary
does not interrupt.
The point is good for your health.
Okay, Chandan Mitra and Renuka Chaudhary, please continue. Please, no, it's all right. Let's continue. Renuka Chaudhary, I request you, let him make his point. We have a couple of minutes left on this debate. It's very important.
They don't have a point. That's the point.
But let him complete. Let him complete nevertheless. Yes.
No. Let me know. I don't want to get down to this level of tamasha that is being this show is often turned into, thanks to certain participants. But anyway, let me say that if there is an inquiry, any probe must start with the Prime Minister, and the Prime Minister cannot be in office when that inquiry happens because it was under his aegis, under his decision, the PMO's decision, PMO's letters, that this system, corrupt system, was established and perpetuated. Therefore, right at the outset, the Prime Minister must resign, and then, of course, there has to be a full-fledged inquiry. Anybody who is found guilty, BJP, CPM, BJD, Congress, whoever it may be, everybody must be punished.
Well,
the position is absolutely clear, honest and transparent. An intellectually, morally and financially dishonest government is refusing to face up to this.
But you're not answering my question on the screening committee.
Arnab, screening committee will have to be probed in any kind of proper investigation. The screening committee will come under the purview. So, this is obvious. But let's start with the Prime Minister. Let the Prime Minister
so that will out, that
inquiry instituted and everything and screening committee will come under his purview.
Now, Chandan Mitra, Renuka Chaudhary, Naresh Gujral and Bharat Kumar Rao, the opposition appears tonight to be completely unforgiving. The Prime Minister says the premise of the CAG's argument is completely flawed. Has it been the correct strategy to expose the Prime Minister in a direct fight with the CAG? We are going to look at that and...